It's a goddamn river, man.
Under the color of night, she crawls into sight. Skin is cold, shadow white. She's a dark angel with dark glasses, dark shadows on the long false lash.
I did it again. Can't find my damn car. Damn. Where the hell is it? Keno crazy.
What the hell's a lorber?
What are you seeing, Night of the Living Dead?
This Millennium Edition says that one of the special features has scenes from the Lost Romero film, There's Always Vanilla. But Arrow just put that out. When is this from?
Isn't it a public domain film still to this day?
It is, but you can own it for $8 if you would rather have it on glorious black and white.
On digital video disc. Full frame edition. What's that?
Jersey's Drew Barrymore movie.
Yes, I have, and it's very good, but Scream Factory released, like, the whole set, and I'd eventually like to get that when it's cheap. That's, put it back on the shelf.
It's a pass? Okay.
Yeah. I came across this, and I still haven't seen the sequel to The Strangers, but for 15 used, I still think I'm gonna wait, because I've heard terrible things about it, and look what I'm doing, I'm, like, bangling this slip, I'm trying to get it in there. There we go.
We're in this half price. I'm about to go. Oh, wow.
A bag of goods.
A tribute to the tripod YouTubers. Looks like the second time I've ever used a tripod on the show. Kind of weird.
I'm a tripod YouTuber.
Yeah, I know.
Sometimes.
Tribute to you, Mr. PMAC Movies, Mr. Joe Martinez. Mr. Team Money 86.
He's not a tripod YouTuber.
Huh? Who?
Does Terry use one?
I think so. Yeah, he uses something. Alright, here we go. Got some films. I'm gonna do a few segments on this program, but we're gonna be using a tripod and showing films that we acquired.
What a novel idea.
Isn't that fantastic?
What do you think?
It's a weird shaped box. Strange.
Rip it and win?
Yeah, pull it. Okay, so my first time ever ordering from Hamilton Book. Found out about them from Mr. Mac. And just go ahead and throw it away. Rip it away.
Rip it and win.
Yeah, rip it. So, Hamilton Book. I can't remember how many I bought. I think there's like 6 or 7 films. Their selection, I wasn't like super blown away. I wasn't like super blown away by what they had. But some of the stuff they did have was really cool, and their prices were very decent. Excuse me, I'm trying to shoot a program here. A lot of the stuff that I found, like boutique label wise, like Shout Factory, Scream Factory, Kino and stuff, like their prices were decent, you know, $16 on some of it, $17, I don't know, but we're going to show you the stuff that we purchased from Hamilton Book.
You purchased? I had nothing to do with it.
Okay, here we go. Let's see what we got. Let's see what's happening. Go ahead and show the first one off. Oh boy.
Office Space.
Amateur tripod YouTubers.
It's supposed to free up your hands. I'm like, what's going on?
Office Space is a great film.
We didn't have it. on Blu-ray.
Yeah, we don't.
Glorious 1080p.
Needed it. Very, very classic at this point, I think. And I think a lot of people that work in an office or even in some sort of relatable field can relate to this film, you know. But so I wanted to buy Office Space on Blu-ray. I think it was $4. Next one is 2 Minute Warning. This is starring Charlton Heston and is put out by Shout Factory. Anybody seen 2 Minute Warning? This one has been on the wish list and it was $7 and usually Shout's $20. So $7 for a Shout. My uncle actually just bought this and I think he paid $20. And I saw it and I'm like, dude, you got ripped off. Hamilton book, $7.
Now you know.
Yeah. Alright, next, go ahead.
Diner.
Mm-hmm.
Steve Guttenberg.
Look at that cast. Look who else is with Steve Guttenberg in that
Daniel
cast.
Daniel Stern, Mickey Rourke.
That's what I'm saying. Daniel Stern.
That's your boy.
That's my boy. It's a great movie. I haven't seen this since I was, I think, a freshman in college. And I really like this one. Like I said,
I never heard of it.
All-star cast. Definitely wanted to buy it on Blu-ray. I actually don't even own the film, so I wanted to buy Diner. I think that was another one that was like $3 or $4. So, moving on. Another Blu-ray we got here is The Freeway Killer. The Freeway Killer. This was another $3 or $4 film.
How many more will die?
This is put out by Image Entertainment.
Wonderful.
Yeah, it's probably going to be bad.
What does it say on the bottom there, on the front?
Where at?
On the front.
On the front with the tag. Based on the horrifying true story of William Bonin. Do you know who William Bonin is?
Based on a true story.
Yeah, you like those. Freeway Killer. Anybody?
Don't.
Anybody seen it?
No.
Okay, moving on. You show this one. What do
okay.
we got?
Okay. Four Weddings and a Funeral.
Oh, yeah.
Andy McDowell.
Oh, yeah. Mr. Hugh Grant and Andy McDowell. Yeah, yeah.
I love Mr. Bean's on there.
Shout Factory put this out, but this is a studio release from MGM because this was, like, significantly cheaper than the Shout release, and I don't need a special edition of this film. I just remember laughing at this when I saw it. So another $4 or $5 film or something.
Orion
so.
Pictures. I love Rowan Atkinson.
Yeah. Okay. This is like the highlight of the Hamilton book order for sure. Monster on the Campus is a new release from Scream Factory. This is a 1958 release. Probably very silly.
The picture on the back looks amazing.
It does. Can we can show that? Yeah, this just got released. My uncle is responsible for getting me into creature features and monster films alike. And I reached out to him and I asked him about this flick. And I said, hey, what do you know about this? Have you seen it? He said, I saw it at the theater when I was a kid. I loved it. So I'm pretty sure I just helped Shout Factory sell another copy of Monster on the Campus. But this was $16 and I think it's 22 or 24 new. So, I mean, it's not like oh my God, it's such a great deal, but it was one film that I really wanted. So this is my favorite pick from Hamilton Book for sure. And last but not least,
The Ghost of Mr. Chicken.
Don Knotts. How can you go wrong? How can you go wrong?
Yeah.
I think some people actually watch this like on a yearly, traditionally basis. Me, I haven't seen it in so long. They screened it at a theater near my house recently and I missed it. So now I can screen it at my house in high definition.
I've only seen it once on Svengoolie.
Yeah.
I loved it.
It's going to be great to watch in high definition, absolutely.
Don Knotts is a weirdo.
So, we're going to move on to some Keeny Weenies, some Kino Lorbers.
Louis, what's your favorite?
They are my favorite label. Let's see. They had their 5th anniversary sale. They've been around for 5 years.
Happy birthday.
Yeah. I really appreciate Kino's releases. I feel like they actually put a lot of time and effort into their releases.
I think I found out what a Lorber is, by the way.
Really? You solved the mystery. What
I
is
think, well, we know a Kino is German for movie.
Exactly. For film or
for
cinema. Yeah.
Cinema.
Yes.
Okay. Well, a Lorber, I think that's the last name of the dude that created the Kino Lorber.
Oh, really? So it's like Cinema Lorber. Like he's like
Kino Switcher.
Oh, yeah. I mean, if that's what you want to do, you know, that's okay.
So I like it.
We're going to go ahead and start with the Kino Lorber 5th Anniversary Studio Classic Sale. And this is part of the order. I'm still waiting on another order coming in. But we're going to splice that right into this footage of this tripod YouTube special for you.
Whoa.
Unstrung Heroes with Annie McDowell. Another Annie McDowell film in this pickup video.
Not surprising.
Mike, I do like Annie McDowell. I really do. I think she's awesome. Michael Richards.
I don't like her accent.
You don't?
It irritates me.
She's from South Carolina.
And I don't like that.
What's wrong with somebody from South Carolina?
Nothing. I just don't like their accents.
Well, I've never seen this. Diane Keaton directed it. It was $6. I think it looks good. It seems kind of like a heartfelt drama. My wife is probably not going to watch this, so... we're going to move on. Go ahead and grab that one. Oh, she showed this.
Whatever happened to Ann Alice?
Yeah, you can show
this one.
That
was on a X-Scene featurette.
Yeah. This one, I think, may have been $10, but...
It was $10, but it was my pick. I was like, you know what?
Yeah, we wanted to see it.
We've been wanting to see it for quite some time, so now
we can.
Look
at the artwork. Looks sweet, too.
Yeah, it does.
Next up, brought to you from the creators of Police Academy, and this is Moving Violations. And this stars John Murray and Jennifer Tilly, James Keesh, from the 80s, 1985. It's a good year.
We've been marathoning Police Academy, so that's right in our vein.
Yes, absolutely. So this kind of goes along with it. Anybody seen this one? I think this was another one that was $10 or $8. I think this was $8. But been on the wish list, wanted to grab it.
I don't know anything about this.
Rod Steiger.
Lake. It does say that.
Artwork, I think, is what sold me, but I like Rod Steiger a lot. I love his portrayal in American Gothic.
He's ex-Marine.
It looks good. I think artwork alone just sold me. It's from 1980. This was $7, I believe. A lot of these have been on my wish list for years now, and like I just didn't want to pay the $20 for it. So
who would?
So for $7, Wolf Lake. All right, Finders Keepers, another like 80s comedy. And this one actually stars a very young Jim Carrey and Beverly D'Angelo.
Yeah.
That cast alone is like worth the purchase of this film, I think. I've never seen it, but...
Yeah.
Kino doesn't disappoint. That's my opinion. They just don't disappoint me. Like, every blind buy I've bought from them, I have not been disappointed. I haven't, like, put in my trade pile, so... Finders Keepers. Right. Next up, go ahead there, honey.
Cops and Robbers.
Mm-hmm.
Bang Bang Cops and Robbers.
Joseph Balakna.
And I don't know anything about that, but I saw the cover art and I was like, my husband would really enjoy that. And I was correct. He did like the cover art.
Absolutely. 1973. Looks fun.
Yeah, that's looks about fun. It.
Yeah, just looked fun. $6. And then this one actually... X-Teen featurette wanted to pick this one up as well, and this is one that actually comes with a slip cover and everything. Look at that. Look at how beautiful that is. And there's like newly commissioned artwork for this. There's reversible artwork, and it's just loaded with special features.
I kind of like the original artwork though.
Me too.
I'm not really digging this artwork, and we have it. So.
You know what?
Oh well.
The reversible artwork may be the artwork that everyone is used to seeing.
Is it reversible?
Film. I'm pretty sure it is. I think this is like one of their collector's editions. I don't know if they deem that on the cover of these releases, which I don't think they do. But this one is like loaded. Cabin Boy, I thought it was a pretty funny movie. Actually, you know what? I can't even remember if I saw this one. But I do know Brian Doyle Murray shows up in this.
He is in it, and it's a... produced by Tim Burton.
I'm interested to see it in all its glory and high definition.
I love Chris Elliott.
Chris Elliott's
big
cool.
Fan.
Yeah. I like this role in Something About Mary. But due to time constraints, we're at 10 minutes. We're going to keep things rolling.
Keep it rolling.
And this is Elliot Gould in Busting. And this is another one that was on my wish list. It looks like a very silly 70s action film. But artwork is the main selling point in this, and price point, I think it was $8, and it's always been $20 on Amazon, so for $8, oh yeah.
Say it. Busting.
Busting on Blu-ray. Let's show it again one more time. Screw the time constraints. Busting.
Busting.
Okay, go ahead, honey. Show this next one.
Bitter Moon.
Bitter Moon, a Roman Polanski film.
I don't know who that is.
He directed Rosemary's Baby, and I believe he's in a lot of controversy, which I declined to comment on.
I forgot. That's that guy, isn't it?
Yeah.
I saw Rosemary's Baby, and I didn't really care for it. But the book's good.
These weird lights from natural light and like the light. Sorry, but
the book's good though.
I've never read the book, never seen the film.
But I don't know anything about this.
I don't have either. You seen it? No, I have not. This was another blind buy. This is a very recent release.
Studio Canal.
It was released in 1992, and for the price, I think it was $9. I just couldn't beat it, And literally, this one, too, just came out as well. The Bedroom Window starring Steve Guttenberg, and this was $9 or something. So I'm like, I gotta grab this. We've been, like, watching a lot of Steve Guttenberg, so it just made sense.
Yeah, just watch his whole career.
His whole filmography, basically. No, not really. He's actually done quite a bit of stuff, but never...
Has he, though?
He really has,
We looked
actually.
Him up when we were watching Police Academy.
He's done. I'd say, a fair amount of work for an actor that achieved his status in Hollywood, I guess.
Wasn't Police Academy, like, his most, like, best known?
I would think so. Yeah, I would say he probably, like, made his name in Hollywood starring as Carrie Mulligan.
I think that was, like, the biggest thing he's ever did, though.
Yeah, but The Bedroom Window looks like a really cool thriller. Dino De Laurentiis presents, so... cool artwork, 1987. Gotta love like older flicks. So, and if you want to grab that next one, this is
no, I don't want to.
She doesn't want to present this one because she's not a fan of Robin Williams, and this is Cadillac Man with Robin Williams.
Like, I'm not excited about that.
I really am because this is a film I've never seen. Gigi and I were talking about this, and he actually thinks I'm gonna really like it. 1990, great year. Same year as my favorite film, Coupe de Ville, which is the poster right there.
So Cadillac Man and Coupe de Ville.
Yeah.
Crazy.
And the same year, but Kino Lorber put this one out, obviously, and can't wait to watch it. Love Robin Williams.
Yeah.
Go ahead, Tony. Let's pick up this next one.
Highway Patrolman. We bought a lot of cop-themed stuff, didn't we?
Yeah, in a way, yeah, we did. Okay, so this is from 91, another blind buy. Another very recent release and at a great price point, so I think that's why I bought this film. But I know nothing about it, read the synopsis, liked the artwork, The Highway Patrolman. Didn't see a lot of people pick any of my titles up.
Yeah, I didn't either.
In the anniversary sale, which makes sense because I really do buy a lot of stuff that I think most eyes... aren't drawn to, I guess. It's weird. I don't know. I just pick out stuff that I find interesting.
I will say, everything that you've picked out from Kino so far, though, I really enjoyed.
Well, I appreciate that.
I wouldn't have chosen one of them, but I have not disliked one yet.
I think it could be luck,
Cadillac
too.
Man? I'm not really looking forward to that. But, okay.
We have one more for this segment of the Kino Lorber 5th Anniversary Sale. Tripod YouTube Spectacular, and that would be Slayground. And she always tells me that I don't appreciate foreign film, and this is a foreign film. This is from the United Kingdom.
Oh boy.
From
how exotic.
I know.
The UK?
The UK. This is from the year 1983, and artwork was the main selling point. I think that artwork, anything to do with like amusement parks
and the title.
Stuff. Yeah, the title's cool. It seems just like a B-movie action thriller, and that's what I gather from the synopsis and from the artwork itself and from what I've read about it. And another very recent release that was very affordable, so I went and pulled the trigger on Slayground. But we're going to edit this video, and we're going to show you some more pickups from the Kino Lorber 5th Anniversary Sale.
Chop and Splay.
Fresh Kinos. Hey, neighbor! Fresh.
More Kino classics. Let's go.
All right.
You gotta fly through it. Go ahead, check out the first one.
The first one, Rawhead Rex. This is the only thing in this order that I picked.
Yes, I've never seen it. Clive Barker's got something to do with it, right? Have you guys seen it? Yeah, I've never seen it. I thought this would come with a slip. Bummer, but whatever.
Whatever.
This one actually does come with a slip. Check this out. The Puppet Master starring Donald Sutherland, old Keefe's dad, Keefe.
Keefe.
Never saw it. 1994, artwork looks sweet, had to snag it.
Sure. The Rosary Murders, also with Donald Sutherland.
Man, a couple Dons, a couple Keefe's dad. All right, Charles Durning, Rosary Murders. PMAC Movies recommended this one from 1987. I trust you, Mac. I'll put it in and give it a watch.
Ooh, this is a recent release from Kino Lorber. The Gun and Betty Lou's Handbag. A fun little comedy from 1992. I wouldn't know if it's fun because I've never seen it, but fun artwork, I can say. What do you think? Is the artwork fun? Do you agree?
Yeah, it's fun.
It looks fun. What do you know? You know anything?
No.
Keep it cruising?
The Border. Jack Nicholson. I don't know anything about that.
I don't either. It's a Universal title from 1982. Good old Jack. Give it a shot. Oh, a film noir with Dennis O'Keefe and William Bendix, Cover Up. Another artwork that sold me, just I loved it. I thought it was really cool. I like film noir. I have a bunch of the film noir titles from Kino Lorber. 1949, looks pretty damn cool.
Sure. The last one is Rush.
Yeah, Rush.
I don't know.
Jason Patrick, Jennifer Jason Leigh. Looks pretty sweet. All these were under $10 or around $10. But I think Kino's awesome. I thought their 5th anniversary sale was rad. Thank you guys for watching the show.
Huh. Huh.